Do the neural correlates of experience, usually abbreviated as NCE, or sometimes referred to as the neural correlates of consciousness, NCC, do they actually explain the source of experience? I don't think so, and I shall share with you why I don't think the brain is the source of experience. But let me first explain what neural correlates are. So the neural correlates of consciousness are the minimal set of neuronal events and mechanisms that are sufficient to actually produce the experience of a specific conscious experience. So I'll repeat that. The NCC, or the neural correlates of consciousness, are the minimal set of neuronal events and mechanisms that are sufficient for the occurrence of a specific conscious experience. So neural correlates could include patterns of synchronized neuronal activity across different brain regions. I think that's, by the way, non-local entanglement, but another issue. Then there are specific populations of neurons that fire in a rhythmic or synchronous manner when you have an experience. And then there's activity in long-range projection cells in the frontal lobes that connect to the sensory centers. Co-activation of frontal and parietal areas of the brain also happens when you have an experience. Experiments have aimed to identify neural signatures or patterns of activity that are specifically associated with conscious awareness, as opposed to just physical simulation or behavior without conscious experience. For example, distinguishing neural activity related to blind sight, which is correct responses without conscious awareness, from activity associated with conscious visual perception. So blind sight is when a person actually knows what is happening without having the experience of seeing what is happening. It's called blind sight. And then there are other examples, identifying temporal properties or interactions between brain regions that correlate with conscious experience. The neural correlates of consciousness represent the minimal neuronal mechanisms that are jointly sufficient for any one specific conscious state, such as seeing a red patch, hearing a siren, remembering a past event. Perturbing or inducing these neural correlates can affect or reproduce the associated conscious percept. So in summary, the neural correlates are the specific patterns of brain activity that reliably correspond to and enable particular conscious experiences, though the exact nature of this relationship is still an open question. So that's part of what we call the hard problem of consciousness. Why do I think that the neural correlates of experience do not explain the source of experience? So here is my argument. The neural correlates of experience in the brain do not fully explain how experience itself occurs. The fact that we can observe certain patterns of brain activity associated with particular experiences does not necessarily mean that the brain is producing the experience. Of course, when we stimulate the brain, then we see the experience reproduced. And this, for many neuroscientists, the ability to reproduce experiences by stimulating different parts of the brain is an argument used by neuroscientists to say that the brain is the source of experience. And of course, this is a compelling observation, as it suggests a tight coupling between brain activity and subjective experience. However, I propose that the neural correlates are not the source of experience, but rather symbolic representations of experience. Just as reading a book can activate memories and experiences, I argue that stimulating the brain's neural correlates is akin to activating the symbolic representation of those experiences rather than directly generating the experiences themselves. So we must then go a little further to see the distinction between representation and source. The key distinction I'm making is between the neural correlates as symbolic representations of experience and the actual source or origin of the experience. I'm suggesting that the brain's electrochemical activity may be a symbolic stand-in for the true nature of experience rather than the experience itself. So when we understand this, the next question is, what is the source of experience? The source of experience is non-local awareness, and the brain is a localized and complex field of that non-local awareness within the infinite awareness. Even the brain and everything that we perceive is a symbolic representation of non-local awareness appearing as that object. So what I'm suggesting is that the brain and its neural correlates are symbolic representations of experience, and only consciousness can produce experience, can be the source of experience. Once again, consciousness is that in which all experience is generated. It is that in which all experience is known, and it is that which modifies itself into all experience, including the experience of the brain, the neural correlates of the brain, the body correlates of neural activity, and the correlates of the body entangled with sensations, images, feelings, and thoughts, also symbolic representations of that one consciousness as the physical world. The mind, the brain, the body, and the universe are symbolic representations of awareness knowing itself as mind, body, brain, and universe. And this understanding solves the hard problem of consciousness. There's no hard problem of consciousness if you understand that consciousness is the source of all experience. Replace the word object with the word experience, and then say, what is the experience? It's a combination of sensations. And what is that combination of sensations? It's an activity of consciousness knowing itself as that, knowing itself as that. Consciousness knows itself both as the perceiver and the perceived, both as the observer and the observed, both as the knower and the known. It's simple. Reading a book evokes the experience and memories, because a book is a symbolic representation of experience. If I write a book, all you're reading is squiggles, which are symbolic representations of thought. And yet you read the book, you get in touch with my consciousness, because in the consciousness that I generated the book and in the consciousness that you read the book, we are one. Knower and known, observer and observed, seer and scenery, lover and beloved, are one. And when we realize that, we are in love with all that exists, all that exists. So I hope this clarifies the confusion between the neural correlates of experience and the source of experience. Let me know if you agree or disagree. But I'm enjoying sharing this with you anyway.